Hi guys, Wayne Jennings here. Today we're at Frontenac Provincial Park in Eastern Ontario. I'm joined by Sean and Jeremy Tucker. We'll be heading off on a 3-day trek through the woods. It's a bit overcast and raining today, but the forecast calls for sunny skies.
Frontenac Provincial Park is located in eastern Ontario, just north of the city of Kingston. Covering an area of more than 5,200 hectares, this natural environment class park contains numerous backcountry-only campsites, linked by more than 100 kilometers of hiking trails and paddle-in waterway routes. Camping within the park requires you to pre-book a specific site. For our first night, we made our way to Doe Lake. This is an easy 1 to 2 hour trek in from the trailhead parking lot.
Thank you very much.
Once camp was set up, we rewarded our efforts with a fine dinner of grilled steaks, mashed potatoes, and Caesar salad. Then settled in to a relaxing evening around the roaring campfire. That first night was overcast and rainy. But by early morning, strong winds had pushed the remaining clouds away to reveal a sunny blue sky.
It was a very loud evening with all the wildlife. The whippoorwills and the loons were driving me loony, but otherwise, it was a pleasant evening, not too wet.
After a leisurely morning breakfast, we packed up our gear and soon departed from the Doe Lake campsite. The plan for today was to hike about a dozen kilometers towards the north end of Frontenac Park, where we had reserved a campsite on McNally Bay, located on Kingsford Lake. There are a lot of trails crisscrossing this park. In fact, Frontenac contains nearly 100 kilometers of hikeable trails. What seemed to impress me most about this park is how well all these trails are marked with signs to help guide you and keep you from getting lost.
So we're here, right at the junction here.
Yeah.
And this goes to Camp 7.
Right. And
who of course, that? It's still very important that you have a good map with you, but it is reassuring when you do come to a fork in the road and all of your route options are clearly laid out for you on these well-detailed signs.
That's a great thing, I guess, about this place is that there's different loops. So you could do a 12-kilometer loop, you could do a 4-kilometer loop, you could do a 40. So I think that's the thing that I think is really neat about this park is you can pick and choose what you want. As for technicality of the park, I mean, you got your ups and downs, but it's not massive ups and downs, and I don't think it's too dangerous of a park, but you do need to be in shape for sure.
I like it here. I haven't been to many parks, but out of the parks I have been to, it's definitely up there with the nicest looking, and like they have nice campsites and everything here. It's been fun. It's been nice to get out in the wild and like have a nice experience in the wild, and it's very, very nice here and beautiful and good scenery to look at, nice lakes.
So here at Frontenac Provincial Park, there are 48 campsites throughout the park, and they're accessible either by hiking in or canoeing in. And when you get to a particular lake, the campsites are arranged in what they call pods. So there's three or four campsites in one area. And even though it's wilderness camping, it's kind of like glamping because it comes with tent pads, so there's a nice level area for you to set your tent up in. It also has picnic tables, so you don't have to eat on the ground. There's a steel fire pit ring. They even have an outhouse, and there's a metal storage bin to keep your food in at night, so you don't have to worry about the critters getting into your food.
On our last morning in the park, we left our heavy backpacks at camp and headed off on a short morning hike to check out the Kingsford Dam, located at the north end of the park. After 2 days of hauling all our gear on our backs, it sure was nice to be able to just get out and go for a walk in the woods without the burden of our heavy backpacks. One of the things I like best about Frontenac is its variety of terrain and scenery. There seems to be a bit of everything here, from thick deciduous forests to open meadows to rocky shorelines lined with windswept pines. At one moment, you'll be trekking through a deep, dark, boulder-strewn valley. Then soon, you find yourself on top of a high, ridgetop trail with spectacular views. There's no shortage of ever-changing scenery in this diverse park.
There's lots to explore, so even if I say, well, we're going to go back to Frontenac, you're not like, oh, we're going to go back to that place again. Well, you could take three or four different types of trails, so I think I like it. This time of the year, I was a little nervous about the weather and the bugs, but not too bad, tolerable. And overall, I think I say I'd come back here in a heartbeat. It's quite a great park.